Hey, what's going on, everyone? Welcome to LTO Youth at Home. We're so glad you're tuning in with us, whether watching on IGTV or the YouTube channel. Thank you so much. Be sure to like, share, comment, and even subscribe if you're watching on YouTube. Click that bell to get more notifications on upcoming videos and content. But guys, all right, I know right now that it's a crazy time, but I believe these videos and this message and worship is going to encourage you. So we want you to put all distractions aside. Take some moments by yourself, whether you're watching it in your room or maybe you're watching it with your family. We hope that this time together in worship is going to encourage you. So we want you to focus in, lean in, close your eyes, take some time to meditate, pray, and sing with us. And we'll be back real soon.
My mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. Body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed with heavy stone. Messiah still in all the
Lord,
so much for worshiping with us. We're going to continue worshiping a little bit, but right now we're going to open up our Bibles. So this is the perfect time to just kind of gather yourself, grab your Bible, grab your notes, and go ahead and grab a pen and a highlighter, because we're going to open up the Bible and allow God to do what God does best, and that is speak to us. I know we're already a little over 3 weeks now in quarantine. It feels like there's not an end in sight, but I'm telling you, when you can just sit, be still, read God's word, pray, worship, it helps. It's encouraging, and I believe it's going to help us in this time. So today I want to talk to you on a topic called "It's Gonna Get Worse Before It Gets Better." So if you're taking notes, the title of this conversation, "It's Gonna Get Worse Before It Gets Better." Have you ever had that feeling before where something bad happened in your life, and you know, one of your friends, maybe a teacher or your parents, try to cheer you up, make things better, but in them doing that or trying to attempt to do that for you, it felt like it only made the situation worse? Has that happened to you before? Or it didn't help at all? Like maybe you were broken up with, or something just bad happened in your relationship, and you know, your friend came along and tried to encourage you with a pat on the back, said, "Hey, well, don't worry, there's a lot more fish in the sea." And you're like, "I don't want fish. I want her." Or you're like, "I miss him. Like, I don't want any other fish," right? And they're trying to cheer you up, but it just kind of made the situation worse. Or maybe you took a test and, you know, you completely bombed it. You got like, you know, a 60, right? And one of your friends, you ask them, "Hey, what'd you get?" And they're like, "Oh, I got like a 95. It was easy." And then you tell them your grade, and their encouragement or trying to attempt to encourage you, they say, "Well, at least you weren't like Billy and got a 40. Right? Like you, in their head, they think, "Oh, that's a lot better." But for you, you're like, "That doesn't make us any easier. That doesn't make this situation better. You probably just made this worse." And I feel like right now in our situation, you've been keeping up with stuff on the news or on social media. One of the biggest phrases we're hearing now more than ever about this coronavirus is this, that it's going to get worse before it gets better. Have you heard that before? I feel like I'm seeing that everywhere. It's going to get worse before it gets better. Now, I read that and initially I'm thinking, "Oh, great, this is awesome. Good news, it's going to get better." But then I backtrack and I realize, wait, you're telling me it's going to get worse? And all of a sudden, if you've been there before, you start thinking about how already it's bad, and you're thinking, how much worse can it get? And by thinking that way, all of a sudden you're now discouraged, and you're just completely like in over your head, and you're thinking, how is it going to get worse? What's going to happen? All these thoughts start running through your head, and you're thinking, no, it can't get worse, right? And then you just have a meltdown. And see, what's crazy is, even though they're not in the same situation as we are today, the disciples are feeling the same way we're feeling right now. See, we're going to go to a book in the Bible called Matthew. And in Matthew chapter 26, the disciples are in a moment where Jesus is telling them, it's going to get worse before it gets better. Now, to give you some context, Jesus and the disciples are having their Last Supper moments before Jesus is about to go to the cross and die. Now, we're lucky to have the Bible and we know the end of the story, but the disciples were living in the middle of the story, so they didn't know what was going to happen. And previous to this dinner, Jesus had already told them, you know, weeks back that he was going to die three times. And they didn't fully understand that. We understand it because we have the word, but they didn't get that. They were constantly asking, "What do you mean by that? What do you mean you're going to die, go to your father, come back to him? What does that mean?" So they were confused, and now they're having a dinner called the Last Supper. And after they ate, broke bread, the Bible says that they worship and sang hymns together. I can imagine now they're starting to get everything cleaned up, washing the dishes, kind of just settling down. And all of a sudden, Jesus begins to stand up and speak up. And he says this in Matthew chapter 26, verses 31. And he says this, "Then Jesus told them, 'Before the night's over, you're going to fall to pieces.'" Listen to what Jesus is telling the disciples. They just finished eating and worshiping, and he says, "Hey guys, before this night is over with, you're going to fall to pieces because of what happens to me." Now, he then goes on to recite a prophecy in the book of Zechariah, and then he comes back after he says that, and he says this, "But after I am raised up, I, your shepherd, will go ahead of you, leading the way to Galilee." In other words, what he's saying to the disciples, "Hey guys, it's time. My time is now. I'm going to the cross, and it's going to get worse before it gets better." In fact, in that moment, the disciples kind of knew what Jesus was saying. So you see Peter stand up and says, "Hey, no, Jesus, you're saying that we're going to fall apart. I'm not falling apart. I'm the rock that you're going to build a church on. And so I'm going to stay here with you. I'll die with you." And that's when Jesus says that famous line, "Get behind me," saying, it's the funniest thing. Go on and read it. But You can imagine how hurt these disciples are. Confused, just overwhelmed. Like, what are you talking about? What do you mean it's going to get worse before it gets better? Jesus, what is going to happen? And exactly what Jesus said ended up happening. Jesus would then go on and get arrested, go on trial. And what's crazy is that out of all the 12 disciples that he would have, one of them is the one that deceived them. And there would also be only one disciple at the foot of Jesus' feet at the cross. All other disciples left him exactly how he said. And so we see this moment and you're thinking, Pastor Joe, how is this even encouraging? What are you trying to say? I truly believe that it's in moments like this we can learn from these disciples. We can learn from these situations and encourage us. And I want to give you three ways that I believe that in a time like this, when it just feels like everything's just getting worse and the better isn't in sight, I believe that we can have peace in the middle of what feels like a storm. In fact, I get these three encouraging things that I'm gonna encourage you with from just the statement that Jesus says in this moment. Because I believe whenever we face problems, we can have peace by referring back to Jesus' promises. Every time you face a problem, take a moment and go back to the promises Jesus gave us, and it'll bring peace in your life. And when Jesus is telling the disciples it's gonna get worse before it gets better, and Jesus is better, he gives us three promises that still resonate with us today. The first promise that he says is he says that I am your shepherd. He says, when I'm raised up, I am your shepherd. He makes it clear. In fact, he's told the disciples and many people this before in the book of John chapter 10. And I love how he states this. He says this in verse 11, he says, I am the good shepherd. So they've heard this before. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. But then in verse 14, he says it again, but I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Jesus is our good shepherd. And what he's saying right now, he goes, although we feel like everything is going crazy and losing control, I will not abandon you. Jesus is telling the disciples in that moment, even though I'm going to the cross, I'm not abandoning you. And right now with everything happening in our life, Jesus is trying to remind you today when he says, I am your shepherd, that I will not abandon you. I know your name. Jesus is telling you right now, if you're watching this, he knows your name and he will not abandon you in this situation. Because that's his first promise. He's our good shepherd. The second thing he says, after I'm raised up, I am your shepherd and I will go ahead of you. Our second promise is he's going to go ahead of us. Now, when he means by going ahead, doesn't mean he's going to leave us in the dust and behind. He's not just taking off and saying, good luck, catch up to me later. No. What he's saying is that I'm already in your future. How encouraging is that, guys? That Jesus is literally telling us that I'm already in the future. The reason why we can have peace in our today is because we know God is already in our tomorrow. Because Jesus said it himself, I'm going to go ahead of you. I'm already going to be there. I'm already going to be on the other side. And that's not because I left you in the dust. It's simply because I want you to know and be encouraged that I'm already in your future. And so trust me and know that I'm in control. And then our last promise that he gives us, not only does he remind us that he is our shepherd, that he doesn't abandon us in tough times, that secondly, that he's ahead of us, meaning he's already in our future so we can have peace in our today. But our third thing he tells us is that he's leading the way. Now, he told the disciples he's leading the way to Galilee. But I believe he's leading our way today, right now. And just as I said, God hasn't left us in the dust. But in fact, like a father, he is walking a step ahead of us, holding our hand like a child and walking and guiding us every step. God doesn't leave us behind, but he is nearby. In fact, not only is God in our future, but God is also in our today. Now, God is not only in the future and ahead of us, but God is also in our present. So we know that he is here with us right now because he's walking with us. He's guiding us. He's leading us. that we don't have to put all of our trust in ourselves, but we can put trust in God and know that He is in full control. Because what I love most, as I conclude here, is that in the moment that they last gather at the Last Supper, Jesus told them that they were going to scatter and fall apart. But when Jesus tells them of this promise, what He's pointing to is not just His resurrection, but Jesus is telling them the better is when we gather again. See, they're gathered in the upper, at the Last Supper, discouraged because Jesus said, you're going to fall apart when all this happens. But then He says, but guess what, guys? We're going to gather again. But this time when we gather again, oh, you're going to have a good story. Why? Because the Son of Man rose again on the third day, and now you have the good news. In fact, the next time they would gather would be in Matthew chapter 28, verse 20, and that's where we get the good commission, where Jesus tells them, guys, I got all power in heaven, and I'm telling you to go and make disciples and baptize people in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and I am gonna be with you every step of the way. See, there was a better. And I just wanna encourage you today that God is in our better. He's in our worst right now because He's preparing us for our better in tomorrow. And I just want to encourage you right now that God knows what He's doing and God is in control, and we can trust and know that He has a better for us. And in fact, we don't even have to wait for our better. It's already here because He rose again on the third day. Guys, I want you to be encouraged in this time. And if you feel a little scared or nervous, that's okay. We're all humans. But let's be reminded of God's promises, because when there's problems in our life, we can have peace by remembering His promises. I want to pray with you today and pray that you would have peace in knowing that God is leading you, He's your good shepherd, and He's already in your future and has it under control. So will you bow your head with me and pray? God, we thank You so much that not only are You present with us, but You're already ahead of us, leading us, walking with us, God, to our future. And God, it is so good to know that You're ahead and You're waiting for us and have the future, our future, in Your hands. God, we pray and we thank You that You sent Your Son to die for our sins that we may have life. And although in that moment it looked like things would get worse, You know that the better was coming. And God, I believe that the sun will rise again in this dark time in our world today. And I know that the better is on the way. In fact, it's already here because we have You. Lord, we know that You already rose again on the third day. So we have the promise. Holy Spirit, comfort us. Give us peace in knowing that we have the power, because the same Spirit that rose Jesus from the grave is the same Spirit that is living in me and in everyone watching this video. So God, we love You and we thank You that we have something to celebrate. We give You all the praise in Jesus' name, everyone said. Amen. Guys, we're going to take another few minutes to worship and praise God that He rose again. In fact, we're going to sing a song talking about His resurrection. So I want you, if you want to continue to reading, you can continue to read your Bible. Maybe take some more notes, kind of just meditate, let this song be sung over you. Or if you want to just sing with us, the lyrics are going to be at the bottom. But let's worship together with a smile on our face, because we have something to celebrate. We have good news that He's no longer in the tomb, but Jesus has risen, and we have the power. We have the victory. We love you guys.
Yeah. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to do this in the midst of the quarantine, Father, in the midst of this dark time. Father, we thank you that you're just guiding us every step of the way. Father, we pray that you help us use this time to develop our character, Father, to develop ourselves in who you are, Father, and to never forget your message and the reason you sent your son down